Hello everyone. My name is Mert Atakan. I am going to make a presentation of our study. It's entitled A Comparative Life Cycle Assessment of Asphalt and Rigid Pavements. According to Turkish Directorate of Highways, Turkey's highways are composed 38% of asphalt concrete and 57% of chipseal, and 5% of other surface types. As shown in the chart, most of the road surfaces are asphalt concrete and chipseal, and there is no rigid pavement in Turkey except for the several kilometers of test section. Why environmental impacts of the road constructions are important? Turkey is a developing country, so authorities attach importance to construct many new roads and to improve current road construction and maintenance of these roads are one of the main reasons of environmental pollutants, including greenhouse gas. That's why it's important to find out the environmental impacts of various pavement types and consider such impacts while planning a new pavement construction or improvement. Differently from asphalt pavements, rigid pavements constructed with joints and steel reinforcement are used in the joints. We designed a jointed plain concrete pavement in this study. You can see basic components of a jointed plain concrete pavement. There is longitudinal joints and we use tie bars in these joints, and there is transverse joints and we use double bars in these joints. The tie bars and double bars are steel reinforcement used in the rigid pavements. What are the basic factors affecting environmental impact of the pavements? Firstly, hot mix is used in flexible pavements, and we should use heating energy to prepare asphalt mixture. It leads an increase in energy consumption. According to previous studies, warm mix asphalt can be used in order to reduce energy consumption. Besides, using reclaimed asphalt pavements instead of normal aggregate can decrease the environmental impacts. When it comes to rigid pavements, we use cement in the concrete, and cement production is one of the big greenhouse gas contributors in the construction industry. And we can use fly ash to reduce its environmental impact. There is tie bars in the joints, and it's made from steel. That's why steel production is also one of the big greenhouse gas contributors in the construction industry. Double bars is also made from steel. It's also one of the important components of the rigid pavements. These are some of the research suggesting that using RAP, warm mix asphalt, in flexible pavements and fly ash in rigid pavement can reduce environmental burdens. In most recent studies, life cycle assessment of pavements have been carried out in three different ways. We use process-based life cycle assessment, and the other way is economic input-output life cycle assessment, and the third way is hybrid life cycle assessment, which is a method containing both option 1 and 2. In this study, the aim is to compare rigid pavements and flexible pavements in terms of environmental impacts. To achieve this, one road section for each rigid pavement and flexible pavements were designed in the same conditions. Then the life cycle inventory was generated for these pavements. For the flexible pavements, usage of RAP, and for the rigid pavements, usage of fly ash was also taken into account. In order to determine the environmental burdens of the products used in payments, such as hot-mix asphalt, ready-mix, Portland cement concrete, aggregates for base layers, dowels and tie bars. The published environmental product declarations, EPDs, were utilized. Life cycle impacts were determined. Within the limits of this study, only the material production phase, namely raw material acquisition and manufacturing the construction products, were studied. When it comes to methodology, the functional unit was selected as the construction of 1 kilometer of pavement. The width of the road was 7.2 meters. There was 2 lanes. The analysis period was 20 years and it is assumed that no maintenance was carried out during the service life. The design of the pavements was made according to ASHDO 1993 design manual, and thickness of the layers were determined. You can see the design parameters in the table. These parameters are determined randomly and they were used for both rigid and flexible pavement design. We use process-based life cycle assessment and only road materials were considered. Construction, usage, maintenance and end-of-life phases are not taken into account. Production of aggregate represents the used aggregate in the base layers. Inventory analysis. Quantities of the materials were calculated according to design parameters. In order to generate inventory data, the EPD values of some companies were used. These EPDs were prepared by the environmental corporations using the cradle-to-gate approach. The list of the used EPDs are provided in the following table. You can see the EPDs used in the study for ready-mix concrete with and without fly ash and hot-mix asphalt with and without reclaimed asphalt pavement, and for tie bars, dowel bars and aggregates. The aggregate used in the base courses. And you can see a close look for the CPDs. Concrete, hot asphalt mixtures, and aggregates, tie bar and dowel bar. And it is an example of the type EPD of tie bars. You can see the system boundaries. The EPD include raw material supply, transport, and manufacturing. In addition to this, it includes waste processing and recycling phase. You can see the other EPDs. System boundaries. It is for dowel and tie bars, as we see in the previous slide. And these are the others EPDs, asphalt, concrete, and aggregate. Determining material quantities of the rigid pavement. Firstly, according to standards, minimum number of dowels, tie bars, and slab length were determined. Slab length determined as 6 meters and required dowel bars and tie bars were determined. And this unit repeats 166 times throughout 1 kilometer. That's why we multiply the numbers with 166 to calculate total quantity in 1 kilometer. You can see the cross-section of the rigid pavement here. According to thickness, we calculated the total volume of the concrete and aggregate. After that, we calculate the weight of these materials. You can see these tables, the calculation steps. These are the rigid payments value. It's concrete slab weights and subbase weights in 1 kilometer, and it is weight of the dowels, and you can see also weight of the tie bars in 1 kilometer, and it's for the flexible pavement. You can see asphalt concrete. We should use this amount of hot mix asphalt, and we should use this total amount of aggregates to construct base and sub-base course. And we also check the dowel sizes with dowel gate to make sure those are sufficient to bear the stress. Inventory data were evaluated in OpenLC software. Widely accepted CML baseline impact assessment method was used. These environmental impacts were evaluated in the study. Acidification, global warming, eutrophication, ozone depletion, and photochemical oxide creation. And you can see a screenshot from OpenLC software when we creating the life cycle inventory. Global warming potential of flexible pavements without reclaimed asphalt pavements is 85% less than rigid pavement without fly ash. Fly ash can reduce global warming potential of the rigid pavement by 29%. Like, RAP can reduce global warming potential of flexible pavement by 10%. As we see in the chart, production of ready mix for uncemented concrete dominates the global warming potential of rigid pavement. In the flexible pavement, production of hot mix asphalt dominates the global warming potential. You can see in the chart also. Production of materials of 1 kilometer flexible pavement leads to 117 tons carbon dioxide equivalent of greenhouse gas emissions. If RAP is used in the hot mix asphalt, it can be reduced by 12 tons carbon dioxide equivalent for 1 kilometer flexible pavement. According to calculator tool of Environmental Protection Agency, a reduction of 12 tons of carbon dioxide equivalent greenhouse gas equals to 180 seedlings grown for 10 years. Considering thousands of kilometers of road construction, using RAP could make lots of contribution to reduce greenhouse gas emission of flexible pavement. You can see the other comparisons of the different pavement options. If we use reclaimed asphalt pavement in flexible pavement, it makes 12 tons of carbon dioxide and 183 seedlings. You can see also in the figure. And if we use fly ash in the rigid pavement, it makes almost 5,000 tree seedlings grown for 10 years. And if we change the rigid pavement with fly ash to flexible pavement without RAP, it makes 670 tons of carbon dioxide equivalent greenhouse gas reduction, and it equals 10,053 seedlings grown for 10 years. You can see the other environmental impacts in these charts: acidification potential and eutrophication potential, similar to global warming potential. These results are also similar to global warming potential. photochemical oxide creation potential and ozone depletion. Conclusion: rigid pavements significantly higher environmental impacts than flexible pavement in all impact categories. Using fly ash can provide a severe amount of greenhouse gas reduction for the rigid pavement. On the other hand, RAP can reduce greenhouse gas moderately in flexible pavement. The production of ready-mix Portland cement concrete dominates all environmental impacts of the rigid pavement, meaning production of dowels, tie bars, and aggregate produces a minuscule fraction of environmental impacts compared to ready-mix Portland cement concrete. The major limitation of this study is to take into account only the material production phase. The study does not evaluate the construction, maintenance, use, and end-of-life phases. That's why further research is required to determine how much the other phases can create environmental impacts. And you can see our references. Thank you for listening. Goodbye.